At a chateau on the edge of Paris, the champagne was flowing. The guests were showing the hors d'oeuvres no pity. It was, after all, a moment to celebrate the 250th anniversary of the birth of a Frenchman who has come to embody good relations between France and the United States.
Relationships between America and France were a little strained at the least, and we thought maybe we could use the spirit of Lafayette as one more opportunity to let his spirit help mend those relations between America and France.
The spirit of the 18th century Marquis de Lafayette has been conjured up a lot this year in France. Perhaps it's witness to how bad things got between Washington and Paris after the invasion of Iraq that diplomats, businessmen, and politicians were pulling out the stops to remember a long-dead Frenchman, whose final resting place is to this day marked with the flags of the two countries he fought for.
Lafayette was just 19 years old when he heard about the Declaration of Independence at a dinner party late in 1776. Caught up in the spirit of the American Revolution, he immediately made plans to cross the Atlantic and go to the aid of those fighting for their freedom. It's a kind of story that the Lafayette commemoration organizers believe has much to say to his modern-day successors.
We will be entering the city.
So, noting that there are nearly 40 cities or counties in the United States which are named after Lafayette, friends of the Marquis invited 10 of their mayors and county officials to come to France for a little historical refresher on what the two countries have meant to each other. They stayed at a hotel called the Concorde Lafayette and went shopping at a department store called Gallery Lafayette.
Lafayette was first,
but mostly spent their time learning about a country many had never visited before.
We in America need to know more about General Lafayette and all the contributions that he made, not just to the United States, but also to Western Europe, opening up Western Europe to the idea of liberty.
There were American ideas coming from the United States and going into France to fertilize, I would say, the democratic ideal. And Lafayette was, in fact, a link, a connection.
Perhaps the biggest project to remember the nobleman turned revolutionary is going on in southwestern France. Using the same materials, if not always the same tools used during Lafayette's day, a meticulous reconstruction is taking shape of the ship the Marquis used to transport himself and his soldiers to help George Washington in his battle against the British. The ship, the Hermione, is being built with millions of dollars of donations and will eventually set sail across the Atlantic to recreate Lafayette's trip.
For idealistic reasons, he decided to go away and to risk his own life for his ideas. That's a great example, I think, for us. And that's why we want to, well, to make people know about him.
And those who've worked to revive Lafayette's memory this anniversary year hope it will prove just as inspirational today as he was to those fighting for freedom on both sides of the Atlantic 2.5 centuries ago. Jim Bitterman, CNN, Paris.